up your voice, my friend. Let's pray. Let's praise him. Oh, to you we come, trusting and believing. God, move your hand. Touch us. Bless your people who are watching today. Father of all, we depend upon you. We look up to you for every need, and we come with an open heart, with thanksgiving. We give you thanksgiving, regardless of what we are going through. We give you thanksgiving because we know that you will take care of everything. We give you thanksgiving, God, because you are worthy. You are the Father who sits upon the throne. And we say, hallelujah, we say, Psalm 27, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the defense of my life. Whom shall I dread? When evildoers came upon me to devour my flesh, my adversaries and my enemies, they stumbled and fell. My friend, do not worry about who or what against you. Because they will stumble, they will fall. Though a host encamp against you, do not let your heart fear. Though war arise against you, in spite of this, you shall be confident. We must trust Jesus. We must trust him. Oh yes, you can bank on him, because he never disappoints you. He fights for you. He is for you. Yes, the gates of hell will not prevail. We are going to talk about that today. In 2013, the Lord decided to visit our church here in Colorado, face to face. When the Lord came, the first day he heard a message from me. Five times he spoke and he repeated, the gate of hell will not prevail. 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 And the gate of hell will not prevail. That's a message for you, pastors. That's a message for you, leaders and the ministers of the gospel. You have a prayer group, you have an evangelistic team, whatever fellowship that you have. Seek God, praise him. The gate of hell will not prevail. God is for you. God does not complain about you. God is with you and for you. Whom shall you fear? Even if the gates of hell are coming against you, the word of God is sure. And it remains, the word of God says, the gate of hell shall not prevail. And so, you need to take courage. Individually, corporately, the gates of hell will not prevail. Even in your private life, in your household, in your home, the gate of hell will not prevail. Make sure nothing of hell is in you. Make sure you are working with God. Make sure you are living holy. And then you can say, the gate of hell will not prevail. But if you're mingling with it, the enemy, playing with his sin, now obeying the scripture 100%, do not say the gates of hell will not prevail, because they can prevail if you are playing with the devil. I told you yesterday, the times we are living in are very strange. This world is getting crazy. The devil, more than ever before, is attacking left and right. But the fact that attacks are increasing is proof that you were the church of God. This past week, the Lord gave a vision to our church. I have not put it yet on Facebook or shared online, but someone in our midst had a vision, and they saw a wagon. You know, like the wagon where you can put your children, and you can put it, and the child is with the father, riding and just enjoying. So the Lord showed that to one of our members, but guess what was inside the wagon? Instead of the child inside, there was my church, blessing Holy Fire Church. Picture that inside there was your church. Because it's his church. And the Lord was like a father, Abba Father. And he was pulling the wagon. And the child is secure, safe. The belt is fastened. He is now worried about a thing. Who can touch you when the father is pulling the wagon? And so it was as if the father was saying, my child, I want you to enjoy the ride. Do not worry about the storm. Do not worry about anything that is coming against you. As I share this, my friend, look at yourself being in that wagon. It's like a baby carrier. If you do not understand the wagon term, it's like a baby carrier where you pull the baby and you push or you pull. And the Lord is telling you, I am your father. Why worry about the storm? Why worry about cars driving by? I will protect you. I will watch over you. The church of God belongs to God. We are going to see that in the book of Matthew, the famous chapter 16, you remember when the Lord Jesus for the first time talked about building his church? So Peter confesses Jesus Christ. As a church, that's what you do. You are preaching Jesus. You are preaching the word of God. Hallelujah. Preach the word of God. Preach the truth. Do not distort it. Do not bend it to feed to people. Preach the word of God. The Lord is proud of those people who are preaching the underrated word of God. In 2 Timothy chapter 4, let's read it very quick before I go to Matthew. Okay. I solemnly charge you in the presence of God of Christ and of Christ Jesus, who is to judge the living and the dead, and by his appearing and his kingdom, preach the word. Be ready in season and out of seasons. Reprove, rebuke, exhort with great patience and instruction. You have the permission from heaven to preach the word of God, to rebuke, to reprove. You have permission to bring discipline among believers. In season, out of season, preach the word, exhort with great patience and instruction. For the time will come when they will not endure sound doctrine, but wanting to have their ears tickled, they will accumulate for themselves teachers in accordance to their own desire, and will turn away their ears from the truth and will turn aside to me. Do not be a teacher, a pastor, a prophet who compromise. Preach, reprove, rebuke, and exhort. That's how Jesus did it. We have to do it that way. And then it says in verse 5, but you, be sober in all things, endure hardship. Do the work of an evangelist, fulfill your ministry. Hardship will come. Hard time will come. Oh yes, that's normal. But we do not quit. We do not give up. We are an unstoppable Jesus army. We march on with great power, with great authority. Now, my friend, listen, in Matthew chapter 16, Peter is the first of the disciples to reveal who Jesus is. And after he tells Jesus who he is, hallelujah, Jesus also says, are you ready? I want to tell you who you are to me. So my friend, do not be afraid to take a good quality time and tell Jesus who he is and tell God who he is, because we have to proclaim his name. We have to proclaim who he is. Oh, we have to write in the sky with our words. We have to proclaim who our God is. Hallelujah. When you do that, the Lord will do the same before the Father. So Jesus spoke in verse 17. Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jona, because flesh and blood did not reveal this to you, but my Father who is in heaven. I also say to you, that you were Peter. See, he changes his name. And upon this rock, I will build my church, and the gates of hell will not overpower it. The gates of hell will not prevail. This is the slogan of our ministry, the blazing holy fire. The gate of hell will not prevail. We live it, we see it. I fight lots of warfare. The Lord has used us. I have a group of prayer warriors. We meet every single day and we pray at least 3 to 8 hours a day together. There are times we do that all night. And our slogan is, the gates of hell will not prevail. Proclaim that. Write it on your heart, in your room, at the post of your household. Write it in the backyard. Write it in the garden. The gates of hell will not prevail in the name of Jesus. Now, look here. Look here. He says, upon this rock, I will build my church. Be fearful and tremble. Whenever you see a church, whether small or big, it's no man's church. Especially the church is powerful when you hand it over to Jesus, the beginning of our church. 10 years ago, I handed him the church. He runs it the way he wants. And when the Lord visited me, he thanked me for giving him the church. And he says, this church has run according to my will. There has not been any other way. I do everything by faith. The Lord has blessed me in some amazing supernatural way. He has blessed me spiritually, financially, and health-wise. I don't get sick. I rebuke you, Satan, in the name of Jesus. I'm covered by the blood of Jesus. I'm covered by the blood of Jesus. The Lord watches over you. The Lord takes care of you. So, my friend, the church is built upon the rock. Who is the rock? The rock is Jesus. Let your church be upon the rock. Preach the word of God. Make it his church. It cannot be his church if there is no prayer. Because he says, my house shall be called a house of prayer. Let it be a house of prayer, then it will be his house. So a church of Jesus, it's a church where there is a prayer. You need to have a prayer every day. Forget about telling people, we will pray from home. No, let's do it together. That way we make sure we do it. And when we have a prayer, do not say, I am a pastor, I will send my delegates. Ever since 2009, my church meets every day and we pray every day. And I am part of every single day meeting. I don't miss prayer. I am there every single day. That's his house. The church is built on the rock. And the gate of hell will not overpowered it. The devil knows the time is up for him. And he is working so hard to destroy the church. One day, the Lord said, come over, I want to share something with you. He began to show me how the church get destroyed. First, you need to know that the devil has satanists all over the world. There are churches that are satanic. They are very well organized. And they have a strategy to send satanists inside the church, but they come disguised. So this is satanist, the first thing they will aim at is to destroy prayer in a church. Remove prayer. They will aim at attacking the pastor. They will aim at befriending the pastor so that the pastor can let his or her guard down. The devil has tried many times to destroy my church, but he cannot. I will not let him. I am a pastor who is awake. But not only that, I have 12 prayer warriors who were awake. Even if I were to doze off, they will chase the devil out. So because the devil could not, there are times he tried even to use the member of the church by giving them a word to me. A word that is very discouraging. A word that will say, oh, that God doesn't like you anymore. You receive a word like that, God doesn't love you anymore, and you believe it, you will be hit by depression. So, my friend, you need to know the word of God. You need to walk with God. You need to stand abreast, tall and strong. And you need to be strong spiritually. You need to walk by the Spirit. How do you become strong spiritually? You must read the Word of God. You must pray in tongues. You must talk to God every single day. You must fast. Because the Bible says, walk by the Spirit. You will not carry out the works of the flesh. Inside of you, there is the Spirit, there is the soul, and there is the flesh. The Bible tells us, your spirit man must lead. Your spirit, the Spirit of God in you must lead. But eventually, among the three I told you, the strongest is the one who is going to win. If your flesh is fat and strong, it's going to win. However, if your spirit man, hallelujah, is the strongest one, God is gonna win. You must put the deeds of the flesh to death. And then the spirit will be strong. We will continue this message tomorrow. The gate of hell will not prevail. This message is to encourage you, pastor, churchgoer, congregation, leaders, minister, fully arm yourself. We have reached another level of warfare. This is a warfare you are going to win by being clothed with the armor of God, Jesus' weapon, bearing them and carrying them everywhere you go. We are face to face with the enemy because the days are evil. And do not be afraid. Do not hide. Do not go to the back of the line. You are going to fight at the front line. You will not be afraid because God fight alongside with you. My friend, I'm about to close and I would like you, if this ministry is encouraging you, building you up, If you fear God, it's time for you to give. You can give by texting 720-586-4390. 720-586-4390. Just text the word give to this number that you see on the screen. I want to pray for you. May God bless you, and then we'll close. Oh, dear Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Touch your body. Touch your church from head to toes. The Lord is delivering you. Be still, be still. Continue to pray. Oh, in the name of Jesus. The Lord deliver you. The Lord sets you free. The Lord hears you. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lay His name alone. Ring through your entire being. And my friend, set you on your feet. Set you on your place. A place where God has prepared for you His place. Stand strong. Do not fear the devil. Do not fear anyone. God is with you. Walk away from your fear, the fear of men, the fear of pleasing men. Walk away from everything that oppresses you. I love you, my friend. God is doing a great work in you. We are going to meet again tomorrow for another powerful teaching together. Let's say this. The gates of hell will not prevail. Stand tall, stand strong. Smile and be happy. Thank you.